McKagan, welcome to the project.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, congratulations on your new solo album, Lighthouse. I'm rapt to talk to you about it, but I can't help but note that you're speaking to me in the middle of a huge Guns N' Roses tour, and this is your only day off, probably in like a year. Is this really how you want to spend it?
Well, I'm home for my day off. We played my hometown last night, which is, there's nothing like it. And to be home, sleeping in your own bed, and I'm doing this interview in my daughter's bedroom. She hasn't lived here for 5 years, you know.
Well, there's one song on the album called I Just Don't Know, which is, it's a beautiful song, and it's quite touching because it feels to me anyway like that's you contemplating your own death and when that might happen, how long you have left. We don't associate that with rock and rollers, right? Is death something you think about a lot?
Rock and rollers are people too. But those chorus lyrics that I wrote, I was walking my dog. It was nighttime, nobody out. And I'm looking up at the stars. And I had this melody in my head for Just Don't Know. And next to us is the lake. It's not the ocean, but it's water. And I looked up and I'm walking my innocent dog. And she just wants to go for a walk. And I look up and I said, the ethers ever glow and the ocean's under tow. I just don't know. And it became this song about, I guess, pondering what's next.
I mean, you have faced death or something quite close to it before. Famously, I hope you don't mind if I ask you about your exploding pancreas. I mean, people may not know the full story of that. What happened and what was that moment like?
That was half my lifetime ago. And I'm 59 now. So at 30, I just drank and drugged myself into a situation where my pancreas burst and sent me to the intensive care unit. And I was pretty close. It was touch and go for a little bit there. And I made it through and I stopped drinking. They said, if you drink when you get out of here, you're gonna die. Your pancreas is exposed. I took that to note and I made it through. My mom had Parkinson's at the time. She's no longer with us. I'm the last of her 8 kids. So seeing her come in to see me in a hospital bed, like with tubes coming in and out of me and she's in a wheelchair, I just, the order of things was completely wrong. I should be taking care of her. Mm. And I felt just, you know, ashamed and pissed off at myself. And so I pulled it together and it was the only way I could really learn. You know, I tried to quit and do all this other stuff. And if your pancreas bursts, that'll change how you think about things.
Guns N' Roses itself, a legendary band / legendary guitarist. It's great to hear that he makes an appearance on this album of yours. And I mean, you've obviously seen him up close for so long. Does he even still surprise you with the quality of his playing?
Nightly. Yeah, I'm his biggest fan. I see how hard he works at it too. He always has a guitar in his hand. And lately, in the last like year and a half, he has a pedal steel that he carries around with him. And nobody can hear him yet. He's like not letting anybody hear him yet, but he practices that like 7 hours a day. So wow. I tell him.
You're a fascinating rock star to interview because of the change in your life, what you've been through, the phases, but also because I think you're the only one I know who has studied accounting.
That's correct.
Like properly, like at university. How does a rock star get into accounting and what have you learned from doing that?
It was like those things I did after when I got sober. I felt like I was behind. I'd like not utilized my 20s to the fullest extent. And so I got into Seattle University. And I thought I could just write them a check to get in, you know. But you can't. And they were like, we need your high school transcripts. And in high school, I left high school. So I had to jump some hoops at what we call community college here, which is like a junior college. I had to take all the basic math and all the stuff. And I was really hungry for knowledge. So I did really well. And I did really well in school. And I learned as much as I could. And I was just discovering who I was, who I truly wanted to be. And so, you know, being a student and being an athlete and meeting my wife, who's like the best thing that's ever happened to me. And there's songs about her on this record. I could write songs for her every day. But meeting her and having our first daughter, Grace, while I was in college was really all killer, you know?
Duff McKagan, solo artist, bass player for Guns N' Roses, guitarist, lead singer, yeah. Father, husband, and of course, finance expert.
Of course.
It's been wonderful to have you on the project. Thank you very much, and all the best with the album.
Yeah, cheers. I appreciate it, guys.